Coach, got a good crowd tonight. Chieftains are playing some good baseball. What do you know about the Bixby Spartans?
Well, like you said, huge game tonight for both teams. Chieftains win out, win both games tonight and tomorrow, and then win this weekend, and then they play Shawnee, bonafide shot to host a regional. Bixby, with both young men that they've got on the mound tonight, Owings tonight and Bennett tomorrow, legit shot to win not just one, but both games. But Chieftains been playing well. Not only have they been playing well, they've been facing quality pitching last week and a half. So what they're going to see tonight and tomorrow is not anything that they haven't seen. In fact, I would argue that what they've seen the last week has probably been as good as anybody in the state. Chieftains, 20-7. Can't remember the last time we racked up 20 wins in a season. You can? Well, it's been a while. And we definitely have paid our dues. We've taken our lumps, and now we're back to competing on a nightly basis, and no longer people assuming they're going to get a win. I think Bixby, more than anything, they're more known for the two arms they're going to put on the mound. I think that offensively they're a little bit, I'm not going to say suspect, but I don't think that their offense quite matches up with their arms. I think that they're formidable. Tonight the Chieftains are putting Cooper Bailey back on the mound. Cooper coming off of a complete game loss last week against Dowasso, but nothing to hang his hat about. He gave up one unearned run in the first inning, and he was lights out from that point on. Chieftains getting ready to take the field on a senior night here at Chieftain Stadium, and looks like we could have a lot of fun tonight.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Chieftain Baseball. The Spartans is coached by Glenn Sullivan and Rossman and Urban coaching the Chieftains. Would you stand, please, and remove your hats while we pay tribute to this great nation with our national anthem? Tonight at first base will be Colson Coffey. At second base is White Sellers. Shortstop, Alan Shibley. And left field is Evan Casey. And center field is Ethan Williams. And right field, Bennett Henderson. Designated hitter is Cody Rossman. And behind the plate is Gage Williams. And on the mound will be Cooper Bailey.
Setting the defense for the home team, Sepulpa Chieftains. First base, Colson Coffey. Second base, Wyatt Sellers. Third base, Kyle Alcorn. Shortstop. Tucker Pauley, number 18.
Number 18, Tucker Pauley. On deck is Jason Krull, and in the hole is Matthew Henderson. Number 18, second base.
Big thing that's important for Cooper, just like it was the other night when he faced Owosso, is constantly getting ahead, being able to mix up his pitches. Definitely don't want to get behind, and where they have a pretty good idea of what's coming. When anytime Cooper can keep people off balance, he's in good shape. Not only does he have a nice little fastball with movement on it, but he's got a dead fish changeup. There's the first strike of the game.
Finally got a nice night to play baseball. Nights like these have been few and far between this season.
The game was originally scheduled for 5 o'clock, and Coach Irvin and Coach Sullivan agreed to move it back a little bit just to let the field have a little extra time to dry out from the weekend rains that we had. Looks like it was a good idea.
Bailey ahead, even in the count, 2 balls and 2 strikes to the leadoff hitter, Pauley.
I like that. Came right at him with another fastball, about knee high, inner half. Didn't mess around with the breaking ball. Didn't mess around with anything off speed. Came right at him and said, here it is, hit it.
Jackson Krull.
Brings up Jackson Krull, the center fielder.
Pop up. Little fly ball that falls in. Looks to me like Ethan Williams thought he had a chance at it. And probably something where he probably should have given way to the left fielder, Evan Casey.
Like Casey stopped on that ball early. Don't know the communication out there, but it looks like that Ethan may have called the ball a little too early there.
Wind is blowing in from left field, so it could have held it up a little bit where he might have thought it was going to crab a little further than what it did.
That ball's hit a mile in the air. Looks like Henderson's drifting back on it. He makes the play, holds the runner at first.
Four-hole hitter Jake Bennett, probably tonight's starter on the mound. Tomorrow night's starter on the mound. Big young man.
Roll this side.
One thing I do like about Cooper is he gets on the mound and he's ready to throw.
A little courtesy move over there to first to change up his looks a little bit.
Must have been a little down.
It's a good location for Cooper. He needs to work down in the zone.
Wouldn't call that an intentional walk, but I would definitely call it an unintentional walk. Didn't really look like there was one we got behind him that we were really going to come back and challenge him.
Hmm?
still takes a base hit to score. I would much rather Cooper be missing where he's missing than missing up. So, as of right now, it's nothing bad. A little adjustment. Shouldn't take a whole lot. It's good. Still missing, though. He's still down in the zone, which is good. The only thing that worries me is Cooper throwing too many pitches early in the game. We want him to try to go as deep as possible. The deeper he goes, obviously, the more effective he is.
Got to get on top of that breaking ball there. Looks like he's on the side of it, leaving that ball up. It's a dangerous place to be.
It's almost like his arm stopped. He didn't come over the top and pull down on it. It's a good spot to miss. The only problem is, he's racking up the pitch count. Again, whenever it doesn't matter how hard you throw, if they know what's coming, they got a better chance to hit it. Ground ball through the left side. Looks like they're going to wave him. Got him at the plate if we catch the ball.
That's a great throw by Evan Casey in left field, the freshman. That ball was right on the money. Looks like Gage, usually a pretty reliable hand back there, just took his eye off of it, or maybe just took it for granted that that ball was going to go into his glove.
Again, though, it comes back to where we've got to get ahead of them. We have to get ahead of the batters. We cannot be behind 3-1, 2-0 every time. Oh. Tap foul. Really good crowd here at the ballpark.
You know, we've had really good support for Chieftain baseball this year with all the success that we've had. It's been nice to see the crowds coming back out again.
Still getting around it a little bit. Digging himself a little bit of a hole.
This may be a case of Cooper just trying to be a little too fine instead of challenging the strike zone.
Three and one.
Probably what the two middle infielders are telling him right now. You got to challenge him. There's not a whole lot of defense for walks.
The veteran middle infield out there with number one, Sellers at second, and number two, Shibley at short. Kids have played a lot of ball together throughout the years.
To the right side. Looks like we're going to have another play at the plate. That time we got him.
That was a nice play by Gage right there, too, to hang on to the ball.
And a fine throw by Ben and Henderson from right field. You know, we could say a whole lot about the first inning, but when you look at it, three base hits and a couple walks, and still getting that up with only one run, got to feel a little bit fortunate. Go to the bottom of the first inning. Chieftains trailing Bixby 1-0.
Three hits, one ball. first base for the Spartans is Jake Bennett. At second base is Tucker Pauley. At third base is Sam Hink. At shortstop is Alex Bighorse. And left field is Blake Williams. And center field is Jackson Krull. And behind the plate is Matthew Henderson.
Leading off for the Chieftains, senior second baseman number one, Wyatt Sellers. Woo! On deck, our left fielder number eight, Evan Casey. Woo!
Off. Fastball right down the middle. Little fly ball. Back behind center field. Right fielder closed quickly. Two starts ago, Mr. Owings went deep in the game against Owosso and didn't give up a run until the bottom of the sixth inning. He gave up two unearned runs, ended up losing the game 2-0. He's definitely gone deep into the game with the quality start. Brings up freshman number eight, left fielder Evan Casey. Looks like Mr. Owings is probably flirting with the somewhere in the low 80s. A little fly ball off to the right. Caught by first baseman Bennett. There's up shortstop Alan Shibley.
Good first swing by Alan Shibley, the junior shortstop. Ball down, evens the count 1-1. Looked like a little slider there from Owings. Shibley a little bit tardy on that fastball. Looks like he's caught guessing a little bit. Be a tough play. Speedy Shibley beats it out. Infield hit. I believe that was a good call by Terry Kimmel over at first base. Good hustle by Shibley out of the box. Multi-talented shortstop. It's going to bring up
first baseman. That looked like first baseball all the way. Didn't really make a move to get there. Go ahead. Brings up Gage Williams, who's arguably the state's hottest hitter.
Looks like we've got some Chieftain alumni here in the crowd tonight as well, looking around. Not sure what the confusion is here on the field. Like there was a little bit of a issue with a photographer over behind the first base line.
Ball away.
Williams hits that ball hard up the middle, but the second baseman is there to make the play and force Shibley out at short. For the Chieftains, no runs on one hit, no errors, one person left on base. At the end of one, Bixby Spartans.
Isaac Smith, if you will please, go to the table behind the Chieftain dugout. You are the winner tonight.
All right. Top of the second inning, Cooper Bailey delivers a first pitch strike. That's going to be key for the rest of the game, is first pitch strike.
Realize it was just the first inning, but it doesn't look to me like the Chieftains are going to be overmatched with pitcher from Bixby. But you know, obviously, first inning, you haven't seen his whole repertoire of pitches.
Alex Bighorse, the shortstop.
Bailey delivers a high fly ball. It's going to stay on the infield. Looks like Shibley's calling for it, and he makes the play. Ball was hit a mile into the air.
Isaac Smith, you're the winner tonight from Bentec Insurance.
Where is he?
That was him.
$30 gift card for Sepulpa Cinema.
It's a good way to start the top of the second inning after a little bit of a control struggle in the first inning for Bailey. It's going to bring up the second baseman for the Bixby Spartans, Kyle Bass.
BSN Sporting Goods.
Tough play in the hole for Shibley. Shibley makes a nice play. Really nice. He made that look easy. That is a tough play. You got to have a really good arm to do that. It's a good job of Colson Coffee coming off the bag to make the catch and the tag there. So a good way to start out for the Chieftains and Cooper Bailey. Two straight outs to start the inning. It's going to bring up the left fielder, number 49, Blake Williams. Ooh, little brush back. I don't think that was intentional.
I think it's important for Cooper to get out of this inning as quickly as possible. I think that's about, what, four pitches so far this inning? It'd be nice if he could keep it under 10.
It's a good pitch. Chieftains have the hitter played straight up, infield and outfield. Ball just a little bit down. He's gone 3-0 on the count. These are the kind of at-bats here that, you know, get the lineup one step closer to turning over. It's a good pitch. These are the
– we're on the subject right now. The batter at the plate is number 49. Can you name – former pitcher for the Yankees that wore number 49. Some people call him Louisiana Liberian.
That's a jam job. It's a gift. It looked like that was a ball inside. And the rib crib trivia question for the night. Number 49 left-handed pitcher for the Yankees was Ron Guidry.
Another good pitch there, coming back in the count. That sickening thud that you may or may not have heard in the parking lot was the sound of that foul ball probably smashing into somebody's windshield. Good at bat. These are the things that Cooper's got to avoid. Got to quit putting runners on base.
Second baseman Tucker Pauley.
So that turns the lineup over. Leadoff hitter Tucker Pauley up. See if the Bixby Spartans start the runner, try to get something going here with two outs in the inning.
Pauley struck out to lead off the game back in the first inning. Not a bad time to send the runner from first. You get thrown out and you got your leadoff hitter starting the next inning.
Ball That's a good pitch, a little tailing fastball away from the hitter. Looked like Pauly tried to pull that pitch instead of going with it. See the middle infielders peeking at the sign to adjust their position. It's a good pitch on the inside half. Now he's got the hitter set up for just about anything. So two outs, runner at first base, leadoff hitter Tucker Pauly up.
If he holds true to what he did last time, he's going to go right at him right now.
Runner goes, ball's tapped foul. Nice play by Coach Sullivan over in third base. Like to see a little show me move over to the first base here to see if you can slow the runner down a little bit, maybe throw off his timing. No, instead he slide steps, and that's a good pitch. So the Bixby Spartans strand one runner. They get no runs on no hits, no errors, one person left on base. The end of an inning and a half. The Bixby Spartans 1, Sepulpa Chieftains 0.
No runs, no hits, no errors, one left on. Bentec Insurance, $30 gift card tonight goes to Isaac Smith.
Number five, senior Ethan Williams. Earlier in the year, Ethan was one of our seniors that signed to play college baseball, signed with Northern Oklahoma College in Enid. It's a good program up there run by Radon Leeton.
Right one.
Like a little
number two in the country.
It's a beautiful facility up there too in Enid. Ethan down in the count quickly, 0-2. Ethan's got good speed. Let's see if he can get on base and make something happen here.
Not a whole lot of wasted time when with Owings on the mound. He's on the rubber and he's ready to go. Definitely not a time of day, though, that's advantageous to be on the mound. It's really, really hard to see anybody in center on the mound or the two middle infielders. You see them shielding their eyes quite a bit.
It is a beautiful, beautiful setting here for a baseball field. It's always been a nice setting with the foliage in the background. But it is a tough sun field for the middle infielders. And depending on the time of year, the left fielder has a tough time seeing the ball. Looks like a little change of pace there that Owings left up. Counts run to 3-2 here. Nobody out.
Already a good at bat by Ethan, getting it at least six pitches into an at bat.
Payoff pitch, fouled off. Good job. Looks like Ethan's really shortened the swing here with two strikes. It's a good approach.
One thing I will tell you about Ethan, if he puts the ball on the ground, he's got a definite shot to beat it out. He can track it down in the outfield as good as anybody.
That's a nice job of putting the bat on the ball by Ethan, not trying to do too much. Ball took a tricky hop on the shortstop.
Didn't really get his body in front of it, but like you said, it did take a kind of a tricky hop. I'm probably going to score that. I'd probably score that a hit.
I'd give him a hit as well. Let's call it a hit. That's two hits for the Chieftains. Maybe the Chieftains benefiting here from a little home field advantage. It's a good aggressive cut there by Kyle Alcorn, the senior third baseman. Kyle's another one of those kids that the core group that's played together for many, many years. one thing you can attribute the Chieftains' success to this year is you've got a number of kids that have played together for a long time, going back to youth ball.
Pitcher definitely needs to keep his eyes on number five over there. Mr. Williams is, like I said, one of the faster kids we've got that's going to be out here on this field tonight.
Got an injury update on Mr. Williams? I know he's nursing a hamstring. Oh, he got picked off. Looks like he's in a rundown now.
Good quick feet by the pitcher Owings there. Quick move. First baseman did exactly what you want to do. You want to have no more than one throw, and that's what he did. Ran him as far as he could and gave the ball up when it was time.
Alcorn at the plate.
So the base running error could prove costly for the Chieftains. Alcorn runs the count to 1-1. 2-1.
Go, Kyle. Stay ahead.
Two.
Looks like that ball had a little cut on it.
It's a good job of Kyle fighting that pitch off. That's a tough pitch on the outside corner, about at the knees. Kyle's going to change his approach here, much like Ethan did at the beginning of the inning. That's just a tough pitch by Owings.
Thing I like it, he's not relying a whole lot on anything breaking ball. He's just coming at him.
It's going to bring up number 19, Colson Coffey, the first baseman. You know, it feels like Colson's been around forever already, and he's just a sophomore. Started last year pretty regularly as a freshman. A little breaking ball that he comes out on popped up. It's going to be handled by the second baseman. And that's going to retire the side. So, no runs on one hit, no errors, and nobody left on base. The end of two. It's still Bixby 1, Sepulpa 0. Trivia for you, sir.
Followed by Matthew Henderson and Jake Bent.
The all-time leader, major league leader, in reaching base on catcher's interference.
Jacoby Ellsbury.
Very good, sir, but he's tied with someone.
I can't say that I know who the co-holder of that award would be.
Correct one.
Do you know what the number is? The number of times?
I'm going to throw out a guess and say 26.
The number's 29. Ball's hit out to left field. Looks like Evan Casey's camped under it. One up, one down for the Chieftains.
One out.
Okay.
Well, I'm waiting with bated breath for you to share the answer to that trivia question.
I'll give you a little clue.
Number 17, Matthew Henderson, catcher.
This person also holds a very important record for hitting. Formerly of the Cincinnati Reds and the Philadelphia Phillies.
Baldwin.
Well, if we're going to go down that road, I'm going to say Pete Rose.
You would be correct, sir.
Baseball's all-time hit leader.
Ball sounds really well hit. That's a great attempt by Evan Casey.
Great attempt by the right, left fielder, Casey. Not a real fan of drifting on the ball, but that shows his inexperience in the outfield. He's usually a middle infielder. He's been transitioned to the outfield a little bit to get him in the lineup. And he'd probably tell you if he turned and sprinted back on the ball and tried to get to a point, he probably has a better chance to make that catch. Not saying he would have, but he definitely would have a better chance. Brings up first baseman Jake Bennett. Ball seems to be carrying pretty well tonight, too. Not a whole lot of wind, but definitely not a whole lot of humidity, not a whole lot of moisture in the air. The ball got a little jump to it.
I missed the weather report tonight.
Ball two.
So Bennett's in a hitter's count here. We'll see what Sepulpa decides to throw him here with a base open.
Looking at the same type of situation that you had last time with Bennett up. Didn't really give him a whole lot to hit. Had an open base. And just basically thought, let's see if we can get him to fish a little bit, and he didn't do it. He took his base. Surprised they really even threw him a strike.
I wouldn't be surprised if I saw a breaking ball or something on a corner out of the zone here from Bailey. Ball's hit really well. Good job by Shibley going to third, eliminating the double. It's a good job, kind of a base running error there by the Bixby Spartan base runner.
Oh, that's a cardinal rule breaker right there. Ball hit ahead of you or at you. You don't go whenever there's no reason to go there. Ball wasn't hit behind him. It was hit in front of him, and he took off late.
Number nine, Sam Hink.
Ball's hit well. Stayed down. Allen stayed down well on that ball and was heads up enough to throw to Alcorn for the second out of the inning.
I got to be honest with you. I'll take that trade any day of the week. Speed on second base as opposed to what's there now on first. I mean, Bennett's not the most fleet of foot. So we got it really a good trade off there.
That ball's popped up. Sellers going out, camped under it.
Wyatt Sellers with the play.
And the sure-handed Sellers makes the play for the third out. So the one out double is erased, snuffed out by the heads-up play by Shibley. Bailey works out of the jam, and it's going to hold the lead at 1-0 for the Bixby Spartans.
Thank you. Cody Blossom.
Mr. Owings is still working. Only giving up two hits, but giving up no runs. Brings up to the plate sophomore DH, Cody Rossman. Swings the first pitch. One pitch, one out. Brings up the nine-hole hitter for the Chieftains. Number three, right fielder Bennett Henderson.
Brings up Bennett Henderson. Henderson shows bunt, takes a strike. Henderson, just a sophomore, getting a lot of playing time this year, earning a lot of starts in the outfield, doing a good job out in the outfield as well. It's a good job right there, running the count to 2-2.
2-2.
That ball is a tough, tough pitch right there. It's a great pitch by Owings.
Get those calls. I thought it was a little bit down, but like I said, if you're around the plate that much, you're going to get a few of those borderline calls.
Second baseman, Wyatt Sellers.
Going to bring up senior Wyatt Sellers. Trying to get something going here with two outs. Slider there. It looked like a slider pulled foul down the third baseline. Not much you can do with that pitch.
At least one more time.
Squibber off the end of the bat. Looks like the first baseman's going to take it himself for the third out. So a quick inning for the Chieftains. It's been a quick game. Into three innings, the Chieftains still trail 1-0 to the Bixby Spartans in this pivotal, pivotal district game.
Another big round of applause for announcer of the night, our athletic director, Jason Clark. Good job,
Brings up the DH, number 19, Blake Mickles. See if Cooper can pound the zone early here and get a quick inning.
Cooper's had a couple innings where he started out and got the first two out. Then he bogs down a little bit and gets behind.
Ball's ripped to right and a diving attempt, and he just falls short. That's a great effort by Bennett Henderson in right. Risky play, too. If that ball's by him, then that's at least three.
The shortstop, Alex Bickhorst.
Like Cooper left that ball up in the zone a little bit.
I think they're going to pinch run for their DH. Probably means there's going to be something on here, whether it's a bunt or whether it's a hit and run, something like that.
It's like Coach Sullivan is realizing this is going to be a close game that can be decided by a run. Looks like number 28, Daniel, is the pinch runner.
Might see Cooper hold the ball a little bit here. See if hitter, see if Big Horse shows his hand. Maybe the runner at first base even kind of leans a little bit. But I always want to see if the hands of the hitter slide a little bit. And he did. He's showing it early.
It's a good move by Cooper to see if the hitter was going to pull that bat back. You don't see a slash bunt much anymore. You do here, though.
I have a pretty good feeling, though, they're going to put the full-fledged bunt on here. They won't take it off now.
I would think that they brought the runner in to steal a base, though. I can't imagine him bringing in a runner just to bunt him over. Third baseman Alcorn in on the grass. Cooper delivers. Looks like a pitch out. And throw down to first. Blocked nicely by Colson Coffey. Looks like the Chieftains may be expecting a bunt here still. Now Alcorn backs up a couple steps. Now he comes in a couple of steps. Bailey comes set at the letters. And the pitch. Ball's hit off the hands. It's a tough play.
Are you kidding?
And we get nothing out of it.
That is just an odd play right there. Ball's hitting no man's land.
Not real sure what the problem was with that ball. May not have picked it up off the bat due to the sun.
Ball just wasn't hit very high in the air. The runner was running too, so I think Sellers was breaking to second base and had to stop and adjust his path.
Now we're looking at the possibility of a big inning for Bixby. Definitely thinking that there's a chance there's going to be a bunt here because we're down toward the bottom of the order.
This is the 8-hole hitter, Bass.
Right there, Chieftains really can't afford to be giving up in a one-run game like this. Already the run that we gave up early in the game was due to a mistake, and we've gotten picked off on the bases. And we've got to start playing a little more clean.
Looks like we got the bunt defense on here. Coffey's well in on the grass at first. Alcorn is shading in at third. Bass is showing bunt. Not real sure. I saw Shibley break toward third, almost like there was a wheel play on, but it didn't look like Alcorn got the signal there.
If Alcorn was going to stay, you probably hope your shortstop would stay at the bag a little longer to hold the runner just a tad longer so you got a shot to throw him out of third. Ow! Coach Sullivan kind of rolling the dice a little bit there, not playing the percentages and looking to bunt. May put it on now, though.
1-1.
It's a good pitch there, a little breaking ball.
1-1, 2 strikes.
Not real real sure why the Spartans took off the bunt, other than they felt like maybe there were some holes opened up on the infield.
I'd really like to see Coffee play back just a little bit. No reason for him to be on the grass right now.
That's an infield fly rule. The batter should be out right there.
Umpires wait to see if it's a routine play. Makes the call for the first out.
One down.
I believe this is a nine-hole hitter.
Left fielder Blake Williams.
Left fielder Blake Williams comes on and comes up to the bat at a critical point in the game. First and second, only one out. If the Chieftains can manage to get a ground ball double play here, this would be huge.
A pick play. You can tell that play was being set up earlier in the previous at bat. A little check swing all the way through there. Shortstop Alan Shibley makes a nice play. Good strong arm. Brings back Pauly, leadoff hitter for the Spartans. I believe he struck out twice, but can't take anything for granted now. We've got to go attack him, be smart with it, knowing we've got an open base.
Yeah, and you got a left-handed hitter on deck here. Not that it matters. Good hitter in the on-deck circle.
I think you need to attack early in the count. If you get behind, then you get a little more careful. It's a good pitch to lead off with, a little breaking ball. Something Cooper hadn't thrown a whole lot of today. Changes the whole dynamic of the at-bat whenever you get ahead on the first pitch. It's a great job by Cooper Bailey and by Gage Williams. Got him out in front, hit it off the end of the bat. Relatively easy play. Chieftains dodge a bullet there. So we go to the bottom of the fourth inning. Spartans leave two runners on base. Chieftains still well within striking distance as we head to the bottom of the fourth inning. Chieftains trail the Spartans 1-0.
What do you want?
bouncing ball to the shortstop. Comes up with it, fires across. Good strong throw for out number two. Two outs. That's going to bring up number seven, the catcher, Gage Williams.
Catcher Gage Williams.
It's a good eyeball down low. Owings has been really efficient with his pitches tonight, working ahead in the counts. Ooh, scary moment, but appears that Gage Williams is okay. Ball just got away from the pitcher, Owings. Looks like the courtesy runner for the catcher is going to be number 10, Garrett Estes.
Garrett Estes trying for the catcher.
It's going to bring up number five, center fielder Ethan Williams. Big spot here for Ethan to try to keep the inning going, maybe parlay this into a run for the Chieftains. Not real sure how that ball didn't get him there. It's a slider that got away. Last two pitches uncharacteristic of Owings tonight, who's had really good command.
Again, I'd like to say, go ahead and stay short. Give him up a few pretty good hittable pitches by trying to get a little bit too big and do too much. We've already established the fact that he can run. So he's shortened up a little bit already, which I like the approach.
Yeah, looks like he's up off the knob a little bit. A tough play up the middle. Ball sneaks through for a base hit.
Finally have a little bit of something going. Senior third baseman Kyle Alcorn. Got a chance to score here, and he put the ball in play.
Nine runs a second, go ahead and runs it first.
Going to bring a visit from the Bixby Spartan coaching staff. Once again, beautiful crowd, beautiful night here at the ballpark. Great old ballpark, probably one of the older ones in the area, but a lot of character here. Field's in good shape. It's always a fast track here at Allen Walls Field, too. Never know which way that ball is going to bounce. It's just about time to light the candles, Coach.
It's about time. But finally, I think the pitchers and the middle infielders are feeling a little more safe out there, so you can see.
It's a good first pitch. Good first pitch from Owings. And a good take. A good take from Kyle Alcorn, who's going to look for one pitch to hit right here, try to find a gap.
Point of game right here.
Chieftains really haven't threatened tonight offensively, so this is an important time to strike while the iron is hot. That ball is skied to center field. Looks like it's going to be a routine play for the center fielder, and that's going to do it for the Chieftains in the bottom of the fourth inning. There were no runs on one hit. No errors and two runners left on base. At the end of four innings, Bixby Spartans 1, Good Guys 0.
Runs on hit, Jackson Poole.
It's going to bring up the two-hole hitter, Jackson Kroll. Should be an easy play for Gage Williams. It's a nice play. Kroll runs well, but not an especially good bunt. If he would have got it down the line or maybe a little harder, he probably would have had a hit out of that.
Brings up the catcher, Henderson. I believe last time he's the one that put one on the wall that Evan Casey just about came up with.
I'd like to see Bailey coming inside there after giving up a big hit last time up for this guy.
If there's ever been a description of a hard luck pitcher, Cooper Bailey might be that person. In 11 innings against Bixby and Owosso, he's given up a grand total of 2 runs. Both runs could have been prevented, and he's had none scored for him. So he's definitely kept his ball club in the game and given them a chance to win. Chieftains need to take advantage of solid pitching performance.
It's kind of been the formula for the Chieftains all year is pitching and defense. Cooper's going to be one they look to next year as well to lead the pitching staff. Kid's got a nice swing. So with one out, one aboard for the Spartans, it's going to bring up Jake Bennett. See if Coach Sullivan decides to start the runners here. Runner. Nice little breaking ball there by Cooper.
Bennett took off on the first pitch there, and I think he might have, as many balls as he's seen in the first two at-bats, he may have had it in his head, I'm swinging at the first pitch, and hopefully I get one.
Ball's chopped over Colson Coffey's head into right field for a hit. That's going to send the runner to third base.
He's timed his jump a little bit.
That's what I'm talking about. Chieftain infield here has traditionally been a fast infield. We've had quite a bit of rain in the past few days. Should you think it'd be soft, but it is a really, really hard fast infield. So a golden opportunity here for the Bixby Spartans with one out and runners on the corners.
Pinch run. I'm sure that Bennett will re-enter. It's like number 4. For
the
Spartans.
Holden running for the catcher.
There's a third baseman, Hink.
That's a nice pitch by Cooper there on the outside edge. Can't say I blame Hink for taking a big hack there. That's worth it, but you got to think here he's going to shorten up and probably try to use the middle of the field.
That type of swing right there, if he makes contact, it's a ground ball to third or short and a possible double play. Get out of the inning.
Great turn by Wyatt Sellers. Bixby Spartan crowd not happy with that call, but that was a good turn. Coach Sullivan not happy with that call, but that was... The runner was clearly out.
Looks like the runner, Hank, was hurt down the first baseline. He might have hit the bag wrong. He's still down.
Coach Shibley, I don't know in situations like these, especially with a 3-man crew, why we're asking for help
when it's the sole job of the first base umpire to make that call. He is the one that's got the best view of that. There is no reason for him to ask for help here.
I agree with you wholeheartedly. The other two have a job to do. They've got their specific things they're checking on, and that's the call. The call's the right call, and the call's made. And I guess the only thing that they were questioning was, did Colson Coffey keep his foot on the bag? Because he definitely didn't beat the throw.
Bixby Spartan crowd, who has been mild to this point, is expressing its displeasure for that call. Coach Sullivan is out of the dugout. Usually a very mild-mannered coach. I have great respect for Coach Sullivan. He is obviously not happy with that call. I believe it was the right call, though.
And to be quite honest with you, if they really wanted to split hairs about a lot of the things, if there was anyone paying attention to the runner going in at into second base, he went straight into Wyatt Sellers with his feet up. So I believe maybe both teams caught a break there, because it could have been an automatic double play anyway with the way the runner went into second base. Kind of the breaks right there that Chieftains need to take advantage of. I'm not real sure if it was a break. Like I said, we both saw the runner out. Now, did he come off the bag? That I couldn't tell you. It didn't look like it. I thought he did too, but it was a great turn. Great turn. I wish Cooper didn't get it to him just as quickly as we'd like, but he got it to him, and Wyatt having the strong arm that he does. Cody Rossman that's Colson Coffey leads off. He's off with a sharp single to left field on a breaking ball. Stayed in the middle of the plate.
Let's see if the Chieftains can capitalize on a leadoff hit after a great play in the top half of the inning. See if Coach Irvin is going to start the runner, or maybe do a little hit and run, or bunt him over.
I think you've got to bunt him over. He's right now. And he did, and it's a nice bunt.
That's a beautiful bunt. Beautiful bunt by Cody Rossman.
In that situation, you've got to go ahead and try to sacrifice the runner over, because neither runner is very fleet of foot, and you're looking at a possible double play. You've got to get the runner to second base. Cody did his job, put the ball down the first baseline. Absolutely nowhere else for the pitcher to go.
It's going to bring up Bennett Henderson.
Wouldn't mind seeing Coach Irvin install a pinch runner in for Colson Coffey. Anything in the outfield right now, it's station to station with Colson. High school baseball, just because you get ran for does not mean that you have to come out of the game. You can be re-entered back into the ballgame. So putting in a pinch runner right now for Colson, especially this late in the game, when in runner in scoring position, I don't think would be a bad idea.
That's a good job of Bennett fighting that pitch off. Yeah, I agree. I agree with the assessment of the speed on the bases. It's going to take a pretty deep ball to score Colson. Ball was well off the plate.
Hit the glove. Crowd saw him hit the glove, so obviously they feel it's a strike.
That's just a great job by Bennett right there. I know you should never look breaking ball, but this is a really good time for a slider away.
He's got him set up.
He definitely has him set up. He's thrown fastball off the plate the last two pitches. Now if he throws a breaking ball in that same plane, it's going to be awfully hard to lay off.
Be a good time for a ball in the dirt as well. Colson's got to really be aware.
He's read down angle on the ball.
He can read the catcher's glove as well. Sees that catcher's glove going the other way. That's a breaking ball, but it was up.
Here. I don't want to put anybody else on base, so I'm probably going to go straight fastball and challenge him.
I think that's what Bennett needs to be looking for.
That's a good job by Bennett. Good job of trying to go the other way with it as well. He's got the right approach. At this point in the at-bat, the hitter's job is to wait for a mistake.
Well, you would think that the coach that's overcalling the pitches for Bigsby knows that the top of the order is coming back up, and he doesn't want to put anybody on base with less than two outs.
That's a great job by Bennett. He's got to be looking straight fastball right here and be very aggressive. Owens comes set, and the pitch, tough pitch on the outside corner. That's just a great pitch. Can't fault Bennett there.
All right, now you go back to the top of the order. You get Wyatt Sellers. The way that they pitched him last, they threw him two breaking balls in a row to start off with. I'm not real sure if I wouldn't be looking right now for a breaking ball. Hate looking at breaking ball on the top. And there it is.
Yeah, I got to think that with the success that Owings had with Evan Casey last time up, that Wyatt may not get a very good pitch to hit. That's a number to third, and it's a great play by the third baseman. And a good dig over at first by Jake Bennett to end the inning, end the threat by the Chieftains. So we've got a great ball game going on here. With a little defense, good pitching.
After 5 complete innings,
fast ball
Spartans lead 1-0.
Just over an hour, game time.
I'm not sure our sponsors are getting their money's worth right now.
Top of the sixth inning. Top of the sixth inning is going to bring up number 19, Nichols. Yeah, he's had a really good swing last time up, lined a single to right field. It's a pretty good pitch there by Cooper Bailey, trying the lower quadrant of the zone. Early 2-0 count on Nichols. Got no action in the Chieftain bullpen right now. Ball's hit up the middle. Sellers gets over, makes a good play, and throws the runner out. Wyatt Sellers showing some good range over there at second base.
Some good range, and he's showing a pretty good arm for a second baseman. That's a second baseman with a shortstop arm.
Yeah, the Chieftains are fortunate to have two guys in the middle who have really, really good arms. That's a nice breaking ball there by Cooper Bailey to start out the count on Big Horse.
Big Horse hit the ball earlier in the game that was right off his thumbs, that kind of dunked in front of Wyatt, a little flare pop-up that we couldn't figure out how in the world the ball got where it got.
Ball skied to right center field. Ethan Williams giving chase. Nice play out there by Ethan Williams. Ball carried a little more than I thought it would. Outfield play for the Chieftains has been really, really good this season. That tonight is no exception, with two really good throws from the outfield to challenge runners at the plate, and then that fly ball run down there by Ethan Williams. It's going to bring up Kyle Bass, the eight-hole hitter, with two outs.
Yeah, in my mind, the center fielder that the Chieftains put out on the field every night, Ethan Williams, is just about as good as anyone around chasing the ball down.
You and I both played with good center fielders during our stints here, who could really, really go and get the ball, and were just really, really sound out in the outfield. Brian Fillmore and Bobby Campbell.
It goes back to the old saying, you got to be strong up the middle. And, you know, you got to have a good quality center fielder that can cover a little bit of ground, then you got to obviously be strong with your shortstop and second baseman.
Of course, your catcher. That's a must. That's a good change of pace there.
That's a good fish changeup that Cooper has.
Haven't seen that. Yeah. He's been behind in the count a lot tonight, too, though.
I'm not real sure if I wouldn't double up on it right now.
Change on a change?
You betcha. Went back to the fastball. We'll have 2-3-4 in the bottom of the sixth inning.
Ball sky down the first baseline. Looks like Colson Coffey's calling for it in fair territory. He makes the out.
So Cooper there, good.
Another stress-free inning for Cooper Bailey, who's really settled down here later in the game. Had the one shaky inning there at the beginning and has really settled down to control the game. Only problem is he's being matched pitch for pitch on the other side by Owings. It's going to come down to these last six outs here. Who can maybe scratch a run across?
No doubt. That's what it's going to come down to. It's going to come down to just executing whenever you get a chance to score a run.
It's the way it should be when you're talking about hosting a regional. Yeah, last week of the season. Last series, district series for Bixby, next to the last series for the Chieftains. You know, this is the way it should be coming down to the last two innings.
Let's be honest. I mean, it's been a while since the Chieftains have been relevant, and we're in the heat of the moment. We're in the battle. We're in the thick of things. Played arguably the number one ranked team in the state last week, tooth and nail to the end in both games. Beaten Broken Arrow, beaten Jinx twice. You know, it's beaten Union twice, and we are in, beat the Sandites. So this is not a fluke, and this is a huge opportunity for the Chieftains. It's just a matter of will we capitalize.
You got to think, too, that come regional time, we're going to have a game like this. We're going to have to win a game like this down the road in an important situation. It's going to bring up to the plate left fielder Evan Casey. Casey takes a good hack at the first pitch and fouls the ball off to the right side onto the 17th fairway of Sepulpa Municipal Golf Course. Owings tempting Casey to go out of the strike zone for that pitch. That's a tough play right there. It's a good job of Owings getting off the mound. Just a little more steam on that ball, and it's by him for a hit. As it stands, it is one out, and that's going to bring up the Chieftain three-hole hitter and shortstop, Alan Shibley.
The shortstop, Alan Shibley. Right one.
Shibley takes strike one at the knees on the inside corner. Like a pretty good pitch to hit there. He swings at a breaking ball and bounces the ball to second base. Ball is bobbled, picked up, and thrown for the out by a half of a step. It's a good swing on that pitch, but Probably missed a good pitch to hit on the first one. As it stands, there's two outs. Catcher Gage Williams at the plate. Owings delivers and a sharp ground ball hit to shortstop. Shortstop comes up with it, fires a strike to first base, and that does retire the side for the Chieftains. So the Chieftains go quietly in the bottom of the sixth. No runs, no hits, no errors, and no one left on base. That was a quick, harmless inning for Owings.
Scored in both the first innings the last two times out. It could have been prevented.
Ball bounced to first base. Should be an easy play for Coffey. Coffey takes himself for the first out.
Cooper's given up a few hits tonight, but there's only been maybe three, possibly four balls that have been centered up pretty good. Everything else has been off the fat part of the bat.
So the Spartans are going to turn over the line one more time with Tucker Pauley. Pauley is over 3 tonight with two strikeouts. It's a nice pitch there by Bailey. Start out the at-bat.
I'm going to be surprised here if we see a few dead fishes that Cooper's going to throw up there. Pauley's geared up. Hit something and yank it. Cooper throws that good changeup. He loved to corkscrew himself in the ground.
I'd like to take this moment to acknowledge our Chieftain TV crew tonight. Doing a good job, led by Chieftain TV sponsor Ray Markley.
Absolutely. And we hope everybody's enjoying this broadcast. All four of you.
Well, That's just a great job right there. He's just had Paulie's number tonight. It's one of those nights. I'm sure Paulie's a very good player. You just kind of tip your hat and you say, "You got me tonight." He'll probably get four hits next game.
Every one of us have had those. If you play long enough, you're going to have one of those nights where you just can't do it.
That's just a nice pitch. His breaking ball's actually gotten better later in the game. I've heard some people attribute that to not overthrowing it anymore. A little change piece there, look like.
Let's make sure we give a little bit of credit to the cat behind the plate, too. Gage Williams called an excellent ball game. He's gotten Cooper through a couple rough innings, but he's definitely has got him through, and now Cooper's kind of in a rhythm. They're working well together, and they're pitching. They're keeping us in the ballgame.
Be a shame to waste this pitching performance by Cooper Bailey.
Too quick. That ball just about curved back in there.
As it stands, 2 balls, 2 strikes, 2 outs in the top half of the 7th inning. Spartans leading 1-0 over the Chieftains on senior night here at Allen Walls Field. Bailey with the pitch. Ball 3.
It's really important that we go get this hitter right here. One, the Henderson, who's on the plate, who's on deck right now, is the one kid who has hit the ball hard every time he's been up. So this is important to go get this one.
Bailey gets a sign. Starts his delivery, the windup, and the payoff pitch. And that ball is tapped to first base. A little tricky hop there for Colson Coffey, but Coffey stays down on the ball, retires a side. That's going to take us to the bottom of the 7th. Chieftains are trailing 1-0. Who are we going to have in the lineup here?
5-6-7.
Absolutely vital. Get Ethan on base, some good things happen. We used to use it, if he can just get on first, it's like giving us a double because he's going to steal second.
Let's see Ethan take the same approach he has all game, staying short, being patient in the box, not trying to do too much with it.
He is up off the knob.
Third baseman is in, maybe expecting a bunt, which is going to open up a little bit of a hole over there at third, maybe even down the third base line if he can wait on one.
I have a feeling Coach Irvin's probably instructing them they're going to take it until they get at least one strike.
That is a borderline pitch. A good take. Umpire's been good behind the plate all night. I will give him. He's been very, very consistent. That's a well-struck ball, but right to the second baseman. Easy play for the second baseman. That's a big out for the Bixby Spartans.
Huge out for Bixby right there. It's Ethan off the bag. Now, basically, you're just playing regular defense. You don't have to worry about butt coverage, Steve. Nothing like that.
like Ethan swung at a little two-seam fastball right there and rolled over on top of one. It's going to bring up Kyle Alcorn for the Chieftains. That's a good take. That's a tough pitch on the outside half there. Just off the plate, a little slider off the plate.
You definitely see how Owings kept better liners.
Ball's up the middle, and that's a nice play by the shortstop for out number two. Now the Spartans are one win away from a big district win.
Defense makes plays. He works quickly, keeps the defense on their toes. Absolutely love watching the kid pitch.
Chieftain's not dead yet. We've got a good hitter up at the plate in Colson Coffey. Guy with good plate discipline, good quick bat. Let's see if Colson can get into one here. I'd like to see Colson with a 2-0 count, maybe set on a fastball and try to get a bat head out and maybe yank one out of here just one time. That's a really good cut. That's a really good attempt right there.
Pretty sure I'd be doing the same thing here.
That's a tough pitch on the outside corner. Now he's got to go into defensive mode up the plate.
He's not just throwing strikes. He's throwing quality strikes. Down and away.
And a three hopper to the shortstop. That's going to do it. That's just a well pitched ball game by Owings. The Spartans did enough on defense.
Another hard luck loss for Cooper Bailey. What can you say? Two consecutive 1-0 losses to both Bixby and to Owosso.
We don't officially give a player of a game, but you got to say the pitcher Owings tonight was. Was on his game, wasn't overpowering, but located the ball well and missed the fat part of the bat most of the night.
Absolutely. I mean, and you gotta credit the defense for the Bixby Spartans. Every play they made, they didn't give any outs. They didn't give any extra outs. Chieftains had a couple opportunities and didn't take advantage of it. And that's all you can say. So, got to get after them again tomorrow.
All right, thank you for joining us here on Sepulpa Chieftains TV.